Hello there guys, and welcome to this here commentary on one of my past games. Basically, I just had to redo it because I know it's boring as hell just watching like an audioless replay only. Anyway, hope you guys enjoy. I'm the fish, over there. And those are the runes I'm using obviously on the left.
Welcome to Summoner's Rift.
I wasn't in the room at this point, so I'm just like casually AFKing. It's chill, don't worry, we win.
30 seconds until minions spawn.
Or do we? Alright, check that out. See, I could hear the smacky noise you get from the cube. But not just that, I could see my, Grasp of the Undying starting to charge. So, I didn't want to face check, because I knew there was someone there. The old smackaroonie! I usually, just throw down a, ward there because I have ghost portals, so by the time the jungler comes up there I get a warning ping and I know it won't be long before they come and gank me. Like print playing pretty aggro is the fish level 1 because he's so strong to the capacity. Ooh, lovely. Getting those grafting undying procs. Too bad he regens like a bastard with his passive. But that is kind of annoying me. As you'll see in the gameplay. Did not mean to do that. I wanted to follow him like that. Look at that. Perfect. Flawlessly executed. My god, have you ever seen such perfection? All calculated. Perfectly calculated. As you could see, I barely stepped quite outside of the bush before turning around and keeping all that minion aggro and flashing back into it. I could have tippy-toed one more step ahead and avoided all the aggro, but no, I just couldn't find it myself not to flash ahead. Keep all the lovely attention on my pretty little self. So right around this point, I'm staying down, a bit back, because I'm not quite sure where the jungler is. But now I see her mid, so I continue to try and then just like, ooh, then I sit behind him, avoiding his W through damage. And at this point, I win the fight. So now I've got my E, and as you can see, my lovely grey shield is regenerating most of my life that I lost. I see him way too late, even though he just placed ward. Look at this amazing trick. Look at that. Wait, look at it, and I'm done. Flawless. As I said before. Look at all those minions dying under the tower. Think they bother me? Ha! Not at all! I'm not at all salty about these three minion waves crashing under the tower right now. Just barely standing out of tower range here. We're keeping them outside, obviously, to try and freeze. I don't think it's gonna work. It's only got three of them. But I'd have to try it. Here I immediately engage because he just used his W, which means he doesn't have it for the next fight for the damage that I'm about to do here. That's a bit overconfident, didn't you, my friend? Or did he? Woo! Look at that. Flawless. First kill. Here, I just keep on going, keep on going, keep on going. Keeping that stun, and then the lock follows up and I sidestep. That was obviously all by chance. And here, my way shoving on the tower, so obviously this is my time back. Also, I will die pretty instantly if I stay. Guys roaming, catching the wave in mid. Smart of him. And since he's not here, I'm obviously attacking as fast as I can. Trying to get a plate, but no, the tower hates me. And no. Nope. It's a no. Now he's got his level 6, haven't faced him with that yet, but we'll see what happens. He's looking pretty itchy to fight, so he's pretty confident he's gonna win. There he's ducking away, minion wave, and I barely escaped with my life. By the way, you guys will see the reason why I rush my bumpy cinder or whatever that is that built into Sunfire. It's because the new Sunfire changes that have been made deal damage, increase damage based on your maximum HP, which is why I like combine that with Titanic Hydra, just as much maximum HP damage, like damage of my max HP as I can possibly get. Hit solo min, carry me some minion waves, put him out there, try and sidestep that, fight, but it's okay, I still have my E available. I stun, auto, Hydra, and kill. By the way, if you didn't know, Tahm's Q is basically an auto attack reset. So you can auto Q, auto instantly. As soon as you have your Titanic Hydra, you can basically get a 3-star combo instantly. That's what I've been doing. Which is auto Q Titanic, and then you W straight away. And you got him. Pretty nice. Yeah, I'm nervous as well, because I thought the jungler was coming, so I thought, fuck that. Let me just ROA to the other side of the river and I safely back here. There we go, Sunfire completed. And now this is where I start to upscale him. That he built Taubes into me. It's really weird because my passive and well all my abilities are obviously magic damage. It's a bit odd, not sure why he built those. Anyway, there he goes, probably killing him for unfortunate soul. Yeah, there goes my mid. May she rest in peace. Right about here where I'm starting to regret taking shield back instead of, oh god, what's it called? Anyway, you guys know what I'm talking about, right? It's a rune. Anyway, it's a rune that does extra tower damage, you know, off your maximum HP. I tend to use that anyway, that's my default rune choice these days, because I tend to roam a lot anyway, using teleport, followed by my ultimate, which has so much maximum HP after you have the Sunfire and Titanic Hydra, that you just obliterate tower. Woohoo! You ain't fast enough, bitch! You can't catch me! You can't pull me under that tower! Give me that grass, we've done dying. So I use the shield, so it's like full damage from my W. Give it to daddy! Gone! That's it, from here on it just has no chance in hell of beating me anymore. I mean, my mid is obviously at a disadvantage because he roamed there, but I gained a lot in exchange. My god, just look at that. Yashiro players, Teemo players, I hate you all. Go! love tap with the Q there. Anyway. Didn't quite go down as I thought it was gonna go down. I thought they were gonna try and take mid tower. Oh, and look, there they go. And this is the high open stage. Wildly. But I still managed to get that kill. Because Tahm OP. And there goes Lux. Landing every spell. God tiered Lux. I'm missing a thing. OP, OP. And then I go. Totally not stealing a kill. Kill secure. Massive two ways crashing at top though, which I'm just leaving. Obviously, who cares about such things? Who cares about farm? Farm's so overrated, right? Fisting some wild animals.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
It's all good. All good. Yeah, come on. You don't want any of this now anymore, do you? And you W them, you might devour them. You can like spit them out in a direction that you want and activate your Q at the same time. Which counts as a knock-up during the animation, they can't do anything. So just spit them in a direction and press your Q at the same time. And it's guaranteed hit. So they tend to jump in a direction or flash directly afterwards anyway. Just a little tip. Not tower? Well, I don't care about the tower. Oh wait, oh, hang on a minute. Okay, too spicy. Too spicy! Spicy in the kitchen! Damn. I should have left. Oh, still have those who worry about what they do. Oh, hang on. And they did it! Look at that! And it took two ultimates of my team to take down that one guy. There we go. Finish my Titanic Hydra. Next in line, always, is Wit's End. I love Wit's End on the fish. It's so good. And here I come to save the day! Ooh, hello! Oh, kill secure! Where you going, yes? That was a Q, auto, and instant Titanic Hydra. That's what the double auto attack there was. Here I go to save the day! Now, notice what I'm doing here. I remember this bit. He's trying to duke me into tackling me over that wall so he can get away. And I was like, nope, nah. Make a little sidestep. And then, almost, but not quite. Not quite over the wall, I'm afraid. Look at that, what are we on? Not bad, is it? Seeing as that's such a horrible start. 11 and 3 now. And there we have it. Let's end. This is where Tahm gets really strong. Monkey, gone. Oh, that's not good, is it? Hello there, pretty lady. Nope. Nom 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 nom. Activated the shield just for the shield bash, even though it's basically worthless. I really don't like shield bash. I cannot emphasize how much I regret taking shield bash on this game. Look at that. 380 damage. Here we go, and your boy's taking another dive. And nope, yeah sure, you're too confident. The hell with you, but Tahm, you want something? And ult me, and now it's 1v1. Thank you, Mort, you just killed yourself. I will survive! Woohoo! Come on, show me what you got, show me what you got. You got nothing. You ain't got shit, son. Ha ha ha. Okay, I provoke you with my meme. Yeah, that was actually nuts. I did not, for the life of me, see that coming. That I would survive a three-man gank by myself.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
And they back. Obviously what you do after you kill the whole enemy team, you press B insta. Insta B! Woohoo! Although, fair to them, at this point they should probably be running. They should be backing now, yeah. Took too long. And I was like, hey, well, you know, you guys are up there. I got global ult, global ult, so why not? Make chop up that spirit that's in, increase all my healing, including from the wits end, and Ravenous Hydra. No, the Hydra. Ravenous Hunter, sorry. Nice healing, and obviously it buffs up the heal from your shield as well. If you just leave your great shield to heal the full damage taken. And here I go. Hello, Yas! Proc that wind shield of his. And hit my damn. Feel fancy. Buddy keeping it healthy. Yas goes in my mouth. And I get out of the way. He's trying to body block me so I can't Q him. Heal, so I just turn on him. And he turns back. And I kill him. And look at that, where'd your life go? It's gone. It's at this point that Mord starts to panic. Started panicking too late. At this point, I don't really give two shits about what he's trying. I don't care about his power. You're actually getting away, aren't you? Getting away. Ah, well. Meanwhile, I abandoned my team for the Yashua to murder them all. Good teammate I am. No! And here I die. It's a massive ass deal. But the healing, the Ravenous Hunter healing, and... Booyah, I'm gone! Woohoohoohoo! I did not see that great escape coming. Back to safety, and here we go home. There you can see my team finally starting to catch up. Can finally stand their own ground. Eremir, 21-4. Tower, it seems, while Seth's picking flowers. All good. All goods in the world. Having far too good of a time without me. Come here, my baby! I've got a frozen mallet for you! Ah, boy, why must he be such a pain? Just having fun with him! Oh my god, what? How did he get out of there? He got like Quicksilver or something? That was weird. He hasn't got clan, did he? No. I do not know how he got out there, by the way. Anyway, look at that. Ravenous Hunter healing. I'm not kidding that it's busted on this temp. Look at that. Ravenous. 11k healing. Reasonable, yeah? Cool. On screen, in case you guys didn't believe me, look at that, almost 12k Ravenous Hunter healing.